الإمام مالك بن أنس رحمه الله تعالى used to pick up his teachers when he studied hadith very carefully. He had some criteria in his teachers. Now when you pick up a teacher in a subject of dunya, you need to see his qualifications. Someone having his PhD from Cambridge or Oxford is better than someone having his PhD from an unknown university. For Imam Malik, it wasn't only knowledge and from whom the teacher picked up his knowledge. He looked at his love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for his adab with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, for his awe of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. One of these teachers is Ayyub al-Sikhtiyani. Ayyub al-Sikhtiyani, the scholar of hadith of Al-Madina Al-Munawwara. على ساكنها أفضل الصلاة والسلام, on the one who dwells in it, most precious forms of salutations and prayers. Al-Madina Al-Munawwara. Even when we mention Al-Madina, we send prayers on the one who dwells there. By the way, Al-Madina is Al-Munawwara. Al-Madina Al-Munawwara. It became full of light by Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. There are some people who don't like this name, this title for Al-Madina. They produced a new Mus'haf called Mus'haf al-Madinati al-Nabawiyya. They named it Mus'haf al-Madinati al-Nabawiyya. There's no one single text in history that gives Al-Madina al-Munawwara this name, Al-Madina al-Nabawiyya. It is Al-Madina al-Munawwara. Sayyiduna Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu ta'ala an narrates, as we read in the Shama'il of Al-Imam al-Tirmidhi, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam entered Al-Madina, everything in it was lit. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam died, everything was dark. Some of the commentators, Ibn Hajar al-Haytami rahimahullah ta'ala, says it was actual light. Actual light added to Al-Madina al-Munawwara during the presence of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. It is Al-Madina al-Munawwara. Ayyub al-Sikhtiyani was one of these great scholars of hadith living in Al-Madina al-Munawwara. Al-Imam Malik wanted to study under him. He examined his reaction to the mention of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. I've known people when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is mentioned, Allahu Akbar! They tremble in awe. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sallam. They tremble. When Rasulullah's name is mentioned, it's like electricity. High voltage electricity stream getting in their body. They change. Just the power of the name of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in front of them. Do you see why the Ummah now is weak, defeated, so much backward, humiliated? Do they know the rank of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Do they have adab with this channel, or to this channel following, yearning, love for this great channel of revelation for the best of mankind sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? We were raised up to do the least expression of our attachment to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When his name is mentioned first in a session, we say, we put our hands on our chest, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. Or put our hands on our faces, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim. And wallahi, I tell you, I have known people, I have seen people who used to do so always on their faces, wiping their faces with their palms when Rasulullah's name is mentioned, saying sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and their faces didn't have any wrinkles. Their faces had so much light because of the barakah of prayers upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. You put your hand on your heart, on your chest, there will be so much sakina in your heart, so much opening in your chest because of the barakah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's name. Abdullah ibn Umar radiyallahu ta'ala anhuma, may Allah be pleased with him and with his father, whenever he had his leg numbed, he would mention Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and say Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallim, and put his hand on his legs and immediately it is cured. Numbing is gone. Ayyub al-Sikhtiyani was one of these people who showed great attachment to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, so that when his name is mentioned, he would tremble, he would sweat, he would leave everything else and turn with seriousness to the person mentioning Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam in full awe and full adab. That's Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. You know, now in protocol, when they say the queen is coming, here in England you have a queen. When they say the queen is coming, you know what's going to happen. Just by mentioning the name, someone is coming. Now you can have Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam listening to you. Rasulullah is listening to you sallallahu alayhi wasallam. He's given the news of what you're doing. Your actions are shown to him. Our relationship to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam is not the relationship of a living man to a dead man. It is the relationship of a dead man to a living man. We're dead, he's alive sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Our hearts are dead because of the dunya. He is alive sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wasallam, giving reports of our actions. These hadiths are very famous and sound. Scholars of hadith such as Imam Suyuti and others say this hadith is sound. تُعْرَضُ عَلَيَّ أَعْمَالُكُمْ حَدِيثُ عَرْضِ الْأَعْمَالِ. Very famous hadith. حَيَاتِي خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ وَمَمَاتِي خَيْرٌ لَكُمْ, and so on. Several hadith on this subject. We are dead and he's alive sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. So when his name is mentioned and you love him, do people notice that this is the one you love? This is your beloved? I'm sure if any one of you proposed to a girl, or any girl was proposed by a young man, and sitting, one of you is sitting with family members around, someone says, this girl did so and so and so, you'll turn, interrupt every other conversation, every other subject. Okay, what happened? Tell me, please. Oh, and you sweat and you get fast beats because you want to hear the news of your beloved. What about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam? We feel nothing when loving him. Let's love brothers, sisters. We're talking about real love here, not fake love of the dunya. Any other type of love is based and built on loving Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and loving Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.